biomechanics is the maths bit of sports science. It's about taking a movement and breaking it down, understanding the forces, understanding how the muscles are working, and understanding how all of these things interact, kind of understanding what's underpinning that movement. In the EIS, you're able to have an impact directly on athletes, and as well as problem solving and understanding questions, you're also able to work directly with athletes who you meet and you get to know, and you help them on their journey towards the next Olympics. And it's really quite inspiring to see how hard they're working and to be able to contribute a little bit towards that. It's about being in the field, so it moves away from kind of traditional views of biomechanics where you're just in a lab and always just coding and doing things on a computer. So while there is elements of that, it's really important that we're collecting data on our athletes directly in the competition environment and the situation they would be in, so that their movement pattern isn't changed to be what it should be in the lab. One of the really important things for us is about looking at the athlete as an individual. So every athlete is slightly different. The EIS is great in terms of its support structure. So we always work as a multidisciplinary team, so you've got knowledge bases from everywhere. So you're trying to understand the whole picture. So as biomechanists, you probably typically end up in a little silo that's kind of you're very technical, and it's not like that in the EIS. We're all about working together with the other disciplines. Because biomechanics is a lot about underpinning movements and underpinning forces and the things that happen to create movement. So that information can really help all sorts of disciplines. So we can work quite closely with physios and strength and conditioning coaches, and we're working towards understanding movement patterns and how they happen. And that can provide huge insights for those two disciplines in particular, but also the coaches themselves. So we can look at technique, and we can look at optimizing the environment in order to learn. Technology is moving us out of the lab, so we're able to work with the athletes in their environments. So be that a new piece of kit that's a wearable technology that allows us to collect data in an environment we've never been able to. So we might be looking at something like kayaking on water or speed skating on ice. There are loads of situations where it hasn't feasibly been possible to actually get movement data before because of the surrounding environment. So as technology increases, biomechanics has to move with it. So we're now able to come outside of the lab and to get really accurate data outside in the field where the athlete's working. So it's really improving our ways of working and our understanding of actually what performance is. You're not kind of modifying performance in order to fit it into a lab or to fit it into somewhere where you can collect data nicely.